This isn't good for radio, I just realized. But he's facing us and he's going like, like making crazy faces like a kid.
You're listening to What a Joke
with Tom Papa and Fortune Feimster
on Netflix as a Joke Radio, Sirius XM Channel 93.
Welcome back, everybody, to What a Joke with Papa and Fortune. I'm Tom Papa.
I'm Fortune Feimster.
And we're delighted to have our guest, Sarah Baker, here.
Woo!
Hi. Thanks. Delighted to be here.
Thanks for coming in.
Even at this early hour.
I know. You look lovely.
Yeah.
So do you. I showered.
Yeah.
You did?
Sarah.
Yes. You're our first guest that's done that.
Yeah.
Yeah. Everyone's very smelly in here. Sarah and I go way back.
It's true.
Tell me your history.
We were at the Groundlings together.
Oh. Yeah.
Sarah was a little bit ahead of me, but we got to do 6 months together in the Sunday company.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, 10 years ago.
10? Oh, wow. Yeah. That seems crazy.
I know.
Sarah and I did a funny sketch where we were, or like one of those bachelorette parties where everyone had dildos.
It was definitely either a bridal shower or a baby shower.
Yeah.
But I don't, what was the like bit?
I don't remember. It was hilarious.
Sounds great.
It's a good premise.
So we were in the trenches together when we were trying to get people to hire us for jobs.
So what did you think? You were there before and then Fortune rolls in. Were you like, you gonna make it rough on her? Like, do you haze them? And do you embrace them?
I feel like we probably, not hazed. Hazed in like
hazed.
A very lame theater person way.
Right.
Like, you need to have all your props assembled.
We're like, what a bitch.
Write 3 sketches a week or you're lame.
But do you make them have to like prove themselves or is it...
No.
Or is it just open arms?
I think it was fairly open arms.
You're just, they've been doing it every Sunday night. At that point, you had been doing it a year.
So you're kind of depleted by the time.
Yeah. They're like, oh, we've done this. It's old hat. And here are the newbies come like, hey guys, who wants to write with me? And everyone's like, I guess I will. and we're trying to figure out the pace. We're trying to learn the pace of it. It's like doing SNL every week, but not on television.
Yeah.
Right.
Lower stakes, but otherwise pretty much exactly the same, except for that we had to assemble our own stuff.
Yeah, you had to assemble all your own stuff, buy all your own props and costumes and wigs. In your head, it's as important as SNL.
More. Maybe more.
Oh, yeah.
You're like, nothing matters but this moment in time and us here at this theater.
Yeah.
It becomes all-encompassing for your life.
Yeah, because it's a lot of work.
It is. Yeah, but it was great training.
Yeah.
And I got to...
And we both got into the Groundlings, so that was cool.
We're fine.
Seems like we're fine. We don't remember any of the details of it, so... The audience is falling asleep. We're like, anyway, so I heard that Sheila was there, but Mark was not.
But now Sarah Baker works all the time.
Yeah, you're in a ton of stuff.
You're in a million things. Currently in season 2 of the Kominsky Method.
Yeah, on Netflix.
Very cool.
Great show.
Yeah, it's flipping Alan Arkin and Michael Douglas.
It's insane.
You play Michael Douglas's daughter.
Yeah.
How's that?
It's great.
Yeah?
He's like a California guy. He's super like laid back.
Very chill.
I mean, he's also the person that like, we'll have had a long day shooting and the next day I'll be like, ooh, I'm tired. And then I'll look on Instagram, which Michael Douglas is on, and he'll be like, have driven down to Palm Springs to play golf. And I'm like, what? He's 75 years old.
Jeez.
But his dad is 102 and had a major stroke and has still like visited us on set.
Oh, wow.
So he has those genes of just go, go, go.
Yeah. Yeah, they're stronger than us.
Yeah, way harder than I have ever been or will ever.
Yeah. And how about Alan Arkin?
Ugh, dreamboat.
Is he funny off camera?
The funniest, loves to do bits.
Oh, yeah.
Talks to everyone.
Oh, God.
But yeah, I feel like, you know, because, I mean, actors admire him so much. He's such a great actor.
So great.
But he loves to do dumb bits.
Does he do magic? He strikes me as someone who goes, do you see this quarter in my hand? And then he pulls it out of your ear.
He's not just a grandpa.
That is not Alan Arkin at all.
He's not just some generic grandpa.
He's a comedy legend.
That is a great bit.
It's a classic bit. You're not
That's
wrong.
True.
You're not
true.
Wrong.
Where did this quarter go? Oh, it's in your ear.
Fortune falls for it every time.
I go, magic!
And do it, could you eat the quarter?
Oh, when he gets your nose?
Where does it go? Who knows?
What kind of bits does he do?
There's a day where he and Michael are filming a scene, and basically the start of it, myself and Nancy Travis are like facing them, but so the cameras can only see us.
Right.
Alan and Michael are facing Nancy and I because they're about to turn in and then walk down this hall for the scene.
Right.
And the director kept. And the directors are great on our show, but, you know, Alan's 85, doesn't necessarily love to be told what to do by anyone. And so they kept giving him a note. Like, remember, Alan, at the top of the scene, like, you know, really hit this his first line or whatever. And so he's facing us. This isn't good for radio, I just realized. But he's facing us, and he's going, like making crazy faces like a kid, like mocking the person, like, and he does that all the time, or he'll come up to me and he'll just be like and make like some like monster faces.
That's a dream to have Alan Arkin doing that to you.
That's fun.
Just for you, not on camera. It's just
he
what a
emails
dream.
Me we email,
really,
we email.
He called me once,
don't worry about it.
He was concerned about how a table read had went and wanted to make sure I was okay.
Oh, really?
That's really nice.
She's heavenly. Yeah, he's the best. And he had his like star ceremony on, and he invited everybody.
Really?
Catering, craft services, dressers, every single person got invited.
That's really sweet.
And a lot of them came in. A lot of them were like, I've never even been invited to something like this before, you know?
Oh, that's so cool.
He's the best.
That's so great to hear.
Yeah.
Do you think...
You're working with legends.
Do you think he'd want to hang out with me?
I can find somebody else to do the quarter trick if that's Sarah? What you're after.
I think Joe can do the quarter trick.
I really wanted that quarter trick.
I've been seeing someone.
Oh. Okay.
And it's getting serious.
Really? Wow. Well, do I get to meet him? I mean, I'm assuming it's a him, but either way, you know, I love you.
Yes, it's a him.
Well, what do I know? When you were in college...
That was one semester, and I was experimenting.
Got it. I know. That's what college is for women. Guys, they don't experiment inside their shirts or skins. I'm sorry. Please go ahead.
And yes, you will get to meet him.
Terrific.
Because we're moving in together.
Okay. Yeah.
And there's one more thing.
No, no, not an actor. You do not get involved with an actor.
He's not an actor.
Thank God. I would rather see you get involved with a Republican.
He's older than me.
So? That's good. A little older means that he's, you know, more mature.
He's not a little older.
But what are we talking about? 10 years? 11 years? 20?
He's closer to your age.
Really? Closer, but lower?
It depends on what age you're going with these days.
Jesus Christ, Mindy, what are you shacking up with, Rupert Murdoch?
You know what? I think when you meet him, you're really gonna like him. You two have a lot of fun stuff in common.
Sure, we both dodged polio.
Well, so what's next? You know, or are you guys like?
We're waiting to see. Yeah, I don't know what's gonna happen.
Yeah.
Because Paul Reiser's on this season, and he is doing. I think he's finishing Mad About You soon, but he's doing like Stranger Things.
Yeah.
And And I don't know. Yeah, so hopefully we'll get to do another season.
Yeah. Well, it's very popular. People seem to love it.
I don't know.
Every time and when award season comes around, boom, there it is.
Yeah, Michael Douglas and Alan Arkin help you get awards.
Was that fun doing that first award season with them?
It was interesting, yeah. I mean, I'd never done it. For me, I'm always like, what am I going to wear? I have to put high heels on, you know. But it was, I mean, I guess, you know, you've been around long enough to in the biz that you're like, hey, if I'm invited, I'll be happy.
Yeah,
because I know that next year I might not be. Yeah, so, you know, try to take it as it
comes. Look at you, Sarah Baker. She really knows how to work the biz.
Oh God, yeah, that's what everybody says about me, Sarah Baker.
Sarah Baker,
Sarah Baker, working the biz.